The search continues tonight for the suspects who shot and killed a man outside a Pritchard gas station.
It happened 2 weeks ago at a store on St. Stephen's Road. Local 15's Christian Jennings joins us now from the newsroom.
Christian, you spoke exclusively with the victim's co-workers tonight.
I did, Greg, and they tell me the victim, Shane Herlong, was killed on his lunch break. Now his family, friends, and Pritchard police are hoping the public will step up and help identify several people police are calling persons of interest in the case. At the Rouse's supermarket in Saraland, a black wreath hangs on the door to the meat department, where 41-year-old Shane Herlong spent most of his time.
Positive attitude, great with the customers. He was a very just outgoing person, likable, laughed a lot.
The laughter ended on the morning of November 11th when Pritchard police say Herlong was shot and killed outside this gas station on St. Stephen's Road.
He left here about 8:15, said I'm going to run some errands, I'll be back in about an hour. And when I got the phone call, it was disbelief. It's like, you know, we were all waiting him just to come back to work.
With no arrests made, Pritchard police are asking for the public's help. They say they're looking for 19-year-old Andelaire Bettis Jr. and 20-year-old Bovaire Brown in connection with the shooting. Police want to question them and three other people whose images were captured on surveillance cameras.
If somebody needed money or something to rob the place, Shane was the kind of person, he would have given them the money.
He was just a really great guy, you know.
Co-worker Penny Honadell says what she remembers most is how excited Herlong was about getting married. He just got engaged last month.
He was excited. He was just giddy, and it was really sweet. You know, there's a lot of guys in the world who are jerks, and you could just see he had a pure heart, and it was just really sweet and refreshing to see that.
Police say they've gotten a couple of tips, actually, since yesterday, and they're following those leads now. A police spokesperson tells me detectives haven't established a motive, though, in the case. Live in the newsroom, Christian Jennings, Local 15 News.